Using power series to solve a homogeneous differential equation, 9x square y double prime plus 9x square y prime plus 2y equals 0. And you are given x equals 0 is a regular singular point. So our solution is given in this form, y equals power series from 0 to infinity, c n x to the n plus r. Take the first derivative, gives me power series from 0 to infinity, c n n plus r, x to the n plus r minus 1. So you bring down the exponent and then subtract the exponent by 1. Take the second derivative, give me power series from 0 to infinity, c n plus r, n plus r minus 1, x to the n plus r minus 2. Again, bring down the exponent and then subtract the exponent by 1. Now, we are going to plug these into this differential equation. So I have power series from 0 to infinity, 9 c n plus r, n plus r minus 1, x to the n plus r. Right? So you have x squared times x to the n plus r minus 2, so 0 minus 2 is 0. Plus power series from 0 to infinity, 9 c n plus r, x to the n plus r plus 1. So you have x squared times x to the n plus r minus 1, so 2 minus 1, which is 1. Plus power series from 0 to infinity, 2 c n, x to the n plus r equals 0. Now we are going to take a look at the power. So we have n equals 0 x to the r, n equals 0 x to the r plus 1, n equals 0 x to the r. So x to the r plus 1 is the highest exponent. That means that we have to run out of terms for these two power series. So for the first one, looking 0, I have 9 c naught times r minus 1 x to the r plus power series from 1 to infinity, 9 c n plus r, n plus r minus 1 x to the n plus r. For this power series, just rewrite it. But if you notice, when I run out term for this one, I'm have n starts at 1, and this already started at 1. So it makes sense to reindex this because I don't have to rewrite everything again. So I'm gonna reindex this to 1 right now to save time. So reindex it to 1. Have 9 cn minus 1, n plus r minus 1, x to the n plus r. Okay? And for the last one, looking 0, I have 2 c naught x to the r. Plus power series from 1 to infinity, 2 c n x to the n plus r is equal to 0. Let me go on to separate these steps. Okay? Now we are going to combine like terms. So this is my leading coefficient for x to the r. Okay, and I have c naught in common, so factor out c naught x to the r. And in parentheses, I have r times r, r squared, 9 r squared, minus 9 r plus 2 times x to the r, plus power series from 1 to infinity, so c n in common, factor it out. What does, and I also distribute this into this one, so I have 9 n plus 9 r. times n plus r minus 1 plus 2 plus this power 3, this term, 9 c n minus 1 n plus r minus 1 equals 0. Okay? Now I'm going to equate coefficient. So let this equal 0, let this equal 0. I have c naught times 9 r squared minus 9 r plus 2 equals 0, and c n 9n plus 9r, n plus r minus 1, plus 2, plus 9cn minus 1, n plus r minus 1 equals 0. So this is our system of equations. Now I'm going to solve for r. So before I do that, I'm going to rewrite this in factor form. So I have, I'm going to use a diamond method. So two numbers add up to negative 9, and their product is 18. So we have negative 6 and negative 3. Don't forget to divide by the lead coefficient, okay? So I have r minus 2 thirds times r minus 1 third equals 0. Then my r is equal to 2 thirds and 1 third. So this is my r values. I didn't solve for c naught because if you set c naught equals 0 and our final solution is y equals c naught times something, but c naught is 0, then y is just 0 and we get nothing out of it. So that's why I didn't solve for c naught. Now we are going to find y1 and y2 using our values. So when r equals 2 thirds, plug it into this one, then solve for cn, solve for the biggest c, which is cn. So I have C in 9 plus 9 times 2/3, so 3/6, 9 in plus 6 times in plus 2/3 minus 3, which is negative 1/3, plus 2 plus 9 C in minus 1 and minus 1/3 equals 0. So C in is equal to negative 9C, negative 9C in and minus 1/3 over 9 in plus 6 and minus 1/3 plus 2. So for this one, I distribute 3 to get rid of the fraction, okay? So I have negative 3C in 3 in minus 1. And on the bottom, if I factor out 3 for this one, so I have 3 in plus 2. Okay, and then distribute that into this one, so I have 3 in plus 2 times 3 in minus 1 plus 2, okay? Alright, here's a, you can see that. Okay, so let me repeat it again. So you have, I distribute 3 into this one, so I have 3 is negative 3 C in, 3 times in minus 1, okay? And for this one, if I factor out 3, what I have left in front of C is 3 in plus 2, and that 3, I distribute it into this one, so I have 3 in minus 1. And then plus 2. And here's a funny thing. It's not funny, but it's important. You cannot cancel 3 and minus 1 on top and bottom because it's not a multiplication. This is the main operation here is addition. So you cannot just cross these out. Okay? If you did that, you would get the wrong answer. And it's starting from 1 to infinity. So when n equals 1, I have C1 equals C in minus 1. Okay, C minus 1 from here. So I have plugging 1 into this one, I have 3 minus 1 is 2, negative 6, C naught. So 1, 5, 5 times 2, 10, 12. Okay, simplify this, I have negative C naught over 2. When n equals 2, I have C 2 equals, so plugging 2, 2, 3, 6, 5, 15, negative 15, C 1 over 2 times 3, 6, 8, 5, 40, 42. So simplify this, so negative 15 over 42, I have 5 over 14, I believe. And what is C1? C1 is negative C naught over 2. So multiply this out, I have 5 C naught over 28. And so my Y1 is equal to X to the R, C naught plus C1X plus C2X squared plus that dot. What is R? R is 2/3. C naught, we don't know, just rewrite it for C1. C1 is negative C naught over 2, but C2 is 5 C naught over 28, plus that dot. So factor out C naught, half x, 2/3, y minus 1 half x, plus 5 over 28 x squared, plus that dot. Okay. Now we are going to do the same thing for r equals 1/3, okay? So r equals 1/3. I have C in, plug in 1/3, I have 9 in plus 1/3 plus 3, okay? And so 1/3 minus 1, negative 2/3, plus 2, plus 9 C in minus 1, and minus 2/3 again, equals 0. So for C in, I have negative 9 C in minus 1, and minus 2/3 over 9 in plus 3. And minus 2/3 plus 2. Okay. Again, I don't like fractions, so I'm gonna get rid of it by multiply to top by 3. So I break this out into 3 times 3, which is 9. So 3 times this, I will get rid of the fraction here. So I have negative 3, Cn minus 1, 3n minus 2. And on the bottom, I'm gonna factor out 3. So I have 3n plus 1. And back 3, I'm gonna multiply this into this one. So I have 3n minus 2 plus 2. And n is going from 1 to infinity again. Same thing. Now when n equals 1, plugging 1, I have 1, 3, 1, negative 3, c. I have c1 equals negative 3, c naught over 3, 4, 4 plus 2, 6. So I have negative c naught over 2. When n equals 2, I have plugging 2, I have c2 equals. So 2 times 3, 6, 4, 4, negative 12, C1 over 2 times 3, 6, 7. 6, 4, 7 times 4 is 28, 30. Okay? Now simplify this, so divide it by 3, no 6, so I have negative 2 over 5, and what is C1? C1 is negative C0 over 2, so this drop out, what I have left is C0 over 5, so now I'm going to write my solution here, so Y2 is equal to x to the r, C0 plus C1, x plus C2, x squared, plus dot dot dot, and what is r? R is 1/3 right here, C0, we don't know, just rewriting what is C1, C1 is C0 over 2, this is C2, C2, C0 over 5. Okay, back up C0. So I have C0 x 1/3, 1 minus 1/2 x plus 1/5 x squared plus other dot. Right? And our final solution is equal to y1 plus y2. Okay? So my y1 is over here, my y2 is over here. So keep in mind that these C0s are not the same. So for the first one, I'll rewrite it. So I have C0 x to the 2/3, 1 minus 1/2 x plus 5 over 28 x squared plus dot dot dot. Plus, so for this one, I'm going to call it C1. So I have times x to the 1/3, 1 minus 1/2 x plus 1/5 x squared plus dot dot dot. Right? So this is your final solution eventually. That's it.
If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.